Hello, everyone. We were seeing the concept of load line and queue point in the last video. There we have seen what is load line, what is queue point, and what is the important to fix the queue point in particular point. And fixing of that queue point, it is known as biasing, the need of biasing. We were seeing that much topic. So the biasing refers to the application of DC voltage to set up the operating point in a such a way that output signal is undistorted throughout the whole operation. That is, that DC value we are fixing in a particular location, corresponding the output DC, that is, without, if we are not giving any input to the transistor or that amplifier circuit, what is the output voltage we are getting? Then you may think, without giving input, how we are getting output voltage? Don't misunderstand. Means, if we want to operate our amplifier, we require external DC supply, isn't it? So, that is actually the supply to the amplifier. Then input means we are giving our voice signal. So without we are giving our voice signal as input to that amplifier, what is the, without we are not giving any input to that amplifier, that is, we are not connecting mic to the amplifier, just to give the supply, then what is the output voltage? That is actually the cue point of that amplifier. What is the voltage? Not only voltage, voltage and current. Voltage, comma, current. And when I am changing the supply voltage, corresponding that output voltage may change. Then that possible value of output voltage and current, it is the load line. And it should be fixed actually in particular value. Imagine the case when we are operating the mic and it is connecting the amplifier. The line voltage is continuously fluctuating. Then will there be a proper amplification will happen? No. What is the reason? Supply is distorted. The distortion in the supply is mixing with my voice signal. Then I am not getting any proper output. So, to get clear output signal, clear output voice, the supply has to fix first. There should not be any distortion there. So, fixing that process is known as DC biasing. Then only Q point will be fixed. That is, the corresponding output voltage is fixed. Output voltage and current is fixed. And again, one more thing. Imagine the case you are increasing your voice beyond a particular limit. Then it is distort. You may hear distorted sound in the mic. So, that's also due to there is a range beyond that it will not amplify by the amplifier. That is, generally in technically we are saying, if the Q point is going to cut off and saturation, it will not amplify. It should be in active region. To keep that Q point in active region, we are using again biasing. So these are the important needs why we are using biasing. Then we are going to see a very important topic. Important topic means you may study in detail in higher semesters, but as an introduction we are discussing this one, voltage divider bias. It has another names: voltage divider bias, self bias, potential divider bias, one more name is the universal bias. Actually, I already told you, we have to fix the Q point, that is the output voltage and current, without giving any input. That DC value exactly in one location, one point. But when amplifier is operating, it may generate heat. Due to this heat, temperature or any fluctuation in the supply or any other thing, normally this coupon may change due to temperature also, it may change. I'll explain that one later. So in such a situation, we have to design a circuit. It has to keep the Q point exact its actual location. When Q point is trying to change in any other location, that is DC Q point, without giving any input, if it is going to change or shift, we have to keep that one to the actual point. Don't misunderstand. Q point will oscillate. Q point will oscillate when you are giving input. That oscillation has a limit. Means if I am saying oscillate means, see my left hand and my right hand. Oscillating means my right hand is oscillating with respect to left hand. Equal up and equal down. If it is again oscillating like this, if I am keeping my left hand little bit up, then oscillation will be here. If it is keeping here, oscillation will be here. Then in this point, if I am keeping oscillation too much up, you cannot see my right hand. Same thing happened for my audio signal or AC signal. The upper portion will clip. Then this reference point, without giving any input, this reference point will be there. So actually this reference point should not have any oscillation or any change. Keep that reference point exact one location. That is actually the concept of biasing. So normally we are using voltage divider bias. This is the general block diagram of there is different biasing, fixed bias, connected to emitter, connected to base bias. Like that, different biasing are there. But normally we are using the famous biasing, that is voltage divider biasing, for the BJT, bipolar junction transistor. It is actually composed of four resistors. For the collector, RC, emitter, RE, these two resistors are there. To the base, from the supply R1, and from the base to ground R2. By combination of these four resistors, we are forming voltage divider bias. Actually, voltage divider bias, the same diagram what we have seen here. In this diagram, imagine we are not giving any input signal here. Okay, and we are not going to take any output also. So imagine this is the case. This circuit we have explained in the last video, how amplification is happening. Last video and previous to that video we have seen. So similar to this one, see, before I am deleting those diagram, you can see along with the input signal, two voltage sources we have to use. One is VCC and second one is VBB. This VBB is to fix the Q point exact one location, and VCC is to give the supply to this transistor. So imagine the case, we have to use two supply, then we have to give input signal also. Two supply to fix one Q point, that is difficult in many of the cases. So overcome that one, what we are going to do right now, take this diagram. We are going to apply KVL to this path, VCC R1 R2. This one, VCC R1 R2. This diagram, I am going to remove this transistor portion. I am taking only this loop. Actually, how this VCC is coming? From this VCC, there is a supply. Then this supply, this is going to ground. Like this it is coming. I am taking this loop, omitting the loop which contain transistor. So I can take KVL like this. Then if you are taking KVL here, instead of I don't want KVL, I want the voltage across this R2. Voltage across this R2. So the voltage across this R2, what I can do? I can apply voltage divider rule. That is total voltage into R2 divided by total resistance R1 plus R2. So now you may clear why the name voltage divider bias it came. Because we are taking the voltage across R2 by using the rule voltage dividing. So voltage divider, by using that rule, I am getting a voltage VB that is actually equal to VCC into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Then from this VB, that is equal to this diagram. See, I can keep that VB here. Then the equivalent resistance across this R2, that is R2 divided by R1 plus R2, R2 divided by R1 plus R2, that I can represent as RB. So I can represent this VCC into R2 divided by R1 plus R2 as a voltage source VB, and equivalent resistance R2 divided by R1 plus R2 as RB. So the same diagram I am getting here. See what is the difference between these two diagrams? Same diagram. This is also same diagram. Then in this case, in this diagram, see VB, it is given here. Then what is actually fixing Q point? Fixing Q point means, I already told you that IC and VC, it should not change. So actually that reference point, it should not change. Which one? This oscillation happens based on a reference point, that is we are normally say as Q point. This Q point is depends on which parameters? VCE and IC. VC means voltage across the transistor and current through the collector, IC. So whenever VC and IC is changing, this Q point will change. Then if reference is changing, then oscillation will be distorted, somewhat like this. But if it is fixed, then oscillation, it will be constant. So to fix that Q point exact that position, we have to fix IC and voltage across this collector and emitter. Normally, understand the case. Transistor is a current control device, means output current is controlled by input current. Current control, current source, that is output current is controlled by input current. So if we are keeping fixing the output current IC, naturally the output voltage will fix. Then how IC is changing, how IC is going to change? IC is changing mainly two factors. One is beta and second one is temperature. Beta means for each and every transistor its own beta. Generally we are saying if BC107, it has a beta 100, but it should not be exactly 100 for all case. Sometimes it will be 99 or 101. If you are saying Swift or Wagner, Wagner has mileage 19 kilometer. Will all Wagner in the same series, it will have same mileage? Some of them may have 20, some of them may have 18, but average we are saying it is 19. Similarly, each and every transistor may not have same beta. Then what is the importance of beta and IC? Actually, IC, that is equal to beta times IB. So if beta is changing from transistor to transistor, what will happen? IC will change. If IC changes, what happens? Q point may change. So we have to fix the Q point without depending beta. That is one important. Second one is temperature. That one I will explain in the next video. Thank you.